Hello viewers, my name is Victor Winka and welcome to another edition of Matters Rising. This is the democracy special and we don't want to talk about the state of the nation. We actually want to look at what is that thing that people are not doing rightly. Or maybe I should say, what is that thing that government is not paying attention to? We're going to be talking about tax. Do you pay your tax? I have two gentlemen in the studio, gentlemen and the lady in the studio. They are going to be telling us something about tax. But by my right is the director of the group, Elder Samuel Okewale. You are welcome.
Thank you very much.
And I also have Mrs. Deborah Salami also in the room. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you. Thank you.
Tell us the name of your association.
Tax Justice and Governance Advocacy Platform of your state.
Okay. This platform, is it sponsored by the government?
No, it is non-governmental organization.
I wonder why an NGO would want to tell people to pay their tax. What is the business of the NGO tax paying?
Because we are serving the role as intermediary between the government and the community purposes.
Okay.
So we let people be able to know, to be aware, and to create awareness, to sensitize them, to mobilize them, and to do what is called civic responsibility.
Okay, thank you very much. But let me ask you, for how long have you been doing this?
Well, maybe I should start from the inception of Tax Justice Advocacy and Governance Platform in Oyo State. The platform was put in place by CISLAC. CISLAC is based in Abuja, it's a civil society group, Civil Society Legislative Advocacy Center. It's based in Abuja. So they went around the states of the nation to put in place the platform in each state to enable such platform to serve the intermediary role as a coordinator, as rightly said, between the government and the people. It is believed that the civil society, they know more, they know better, and they are in the right position to educate and make people aware of their roles. And let government also be sensitized to their responsibilities.
Okay, let me ask you, since you've been doing this, what would you say has been your major challenge?
Well, in the first instance, when we first started, 15th June 2015, this platform was inaugurated. Well, I can say our challenges range from finance, then acceptability by the people.
Acceptability?
Yes, acceptability. When we went around town, we are still going around, to sell the idea of mobilizing people to pay their tax, we met a kind of brick wall. In the first instance, when we conducted our research, we need to conduct a research to have a baseline data on what we are working on. So the research was tagged report card, a community report card on tax payments and administration in Oyo State. So when we were gathering our data, I can cite my own example when I was administering the questionnaire along the whole road. I was almost mocked by the transport workers, road transport workers.
Right.
They said, why am I coming to them to tell them about tax payments? They said they are not interested in paying tax and they will not pay. That each day they listen to news that revenue are being embezzled at the state level, at the national level.
Let me ask you, do you think they have a point? Those are the taxpayers. They say they don't want to pay tax because they feel their money is being embezzled. Don't you think that is something that should be a challenge?
Actually, it is a big challenge because our behavioral attitude of people towards tax payments is nothing to write about home because they are not aware, they are not educated, and they are not even interested because of what is going on in the hierarchy of the government.
Okay, let me ask you, I as a citizen of Nigeria, let's say for instance, I live in an environment where there's no good road, where there's no fine running water, there's no light, and you come to tell me about the tax. How do you want to pay? So how do you convince me to pay my tax?
Actually, people would like to have value for money.
Yeah.
That is, what they pay for, they should have something in as a compensation in the rate. People are looking for good roads, good hospital facility, education, agriculture, and even electricity supply to be regular. So all these, they expect that from the taxpayers' money, all these things will be put in place. But when all those things are not forthcoming, people are being discouraged of even hearing about tax, not to talk even about paying it. But people need to be orientated on this. Which means, if on the side of the community, they do they fulfill their responsibility, on the side of the government too, they need to fulfill their promises.
Should my responsibility, my turnout, it could be as a result of the responsibility of the government. I mean, should I pay my tax because I think that the government is actually using it to do what I want them to do for, or I should just pay regardless of?
Well, every human being is a rational being. So, definitely, if people are doing something, whatever you are doing, nobody will do something without having it in mind to get something positive from it. Since inception, we heard that people were being given orientation to pay tax. And I can remember that time they were saying, oh, Rito de Baba Lupo song, I want to song, meaning that when they started the idea of paying tax, those that were not ready to pay were locked up. And that time, I can remember people saw value for money. Maybe during that time was a period free education was introduced in the Western region and all that. But these days, the community people are dragging their feet because all the so-called infrastructure, what we have now is decaying infrastructure. So, and they feel within their minds, each day they listen to news that so-so amount of money has been stolen, so-so amount of money are kept in private vaults. And I think this is responsible for people showing their resentment towards paying anything to government. And this is even reflected in one of our jingles. In the jingle, the person talking there said, somebody was bringing some papers, then I've just gone to pay my tax. Why? The money that you have paid, that they will come round, sit down at a round table, and divide and take away. Nothing will be given in return to the people that are paying. He said, and that man who has a sensitized mind, now educating the other person that, things have changed. The money that we are now paying, they are properly recorded. There is record for it. And government has promised to use this fund judiciously to provide social services to the people. And that person just said, if that is it, let me just go and pay money. That is part of our effort to sensitize, to reorientate, to make the people have a thing. And we, in our own small way, we are also meeting the agencies in the government.
That's really my last question now. Okay. You've been talking about people, you've been meeting people, and you've been getting feedback from them. Have you been going back to the government? And how has been their response?
Yes, we are okay.
Thank you very much. The adage says, what is good for Bush is also good for Canada. As we go to the community, sensitizing them, mobilizing them, educating them, to be able to fulfill their social and civic responsibility. The same way, since we are intermediary, we go to the government through their agencies in order to actually let them know the response of the community towards paying taxes. And what is expected of the government to fulfill their promise as to providing the necessary amenities. such as what our poster is actually talking about, that we to be patriotic, pay your tax. Let the government also be accountable for the tax collected, like in the area of electricity, water supply, agriculture, hospital, school, and good road. All these are expected from the government to be able to cater for the taxpayers. So we are also letting them know. Like just 3 days ago, we are in the head board of Internal Revenue. The directors and all their team, with the team of our platform, we met together and in order to fashion out mutual collaboration between us and them, and to let them know what is going on in the community and what is expected of them. So we have been doing that, and as a result, we are getting good response and good promises for the government, which we actually laid the fear of the people and be ready to pay as the government is promising to fulfill their obligation.
Thank you very much, Mr. Okiwe. Thank you very much, Mr. Salami.
Thank you.
It is, you've heard it all about tax. It is for no reason at all if you don't have to pay your tax. Think about patriotism and think about the growth for the next generation. Thank you very much.
Conscience.
And the conscience. Please keep your comments running on the Tribune Online platform, and we would like to see your feedback on this. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.